Ladies and gentlemen, hey, hi, how you doing? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. With season 4, obviously there was a lot of weapon changes with attachments and with just general weapon tuning, and one weapon in particular jumped up a lot in terms of overall efficiency, and that is the Milano. The Milano prior to season 4 was one of the worst guns in the game. It had a slow fire rate, its damage was not really good whatsoever. Like, for an SMG especially, it was really not competitive at all. For an overall weapon, it was really not competitive. But now, thanks to all the buffs that it got with the Season 4 update, the Milano is actually one of the better SMGs, and at this very moment, it's actually sort of secretly broken. So today we are covering why the Milano is so good right now, why it's, a very, very competitive SMG, and especially a fantastic hybrid SMG, and also how it is secretly broken. So if you enjoy the video at any point, or if you find it helpful, let me know by dropping a like on it. It would be seriously appreciated. And of course, if you're new to the channel, or if you haven't already subscribed, I am always covering everything going on in COD. News, updates, loadouts, it's all right here. So feel free to subscribe, that way you can always stay up to date. So the first thing I want to look at when it comes to the Milano is just the general stats of it, how it competes against other SMGs in the game right now. And we've got like the basic setup for pretty much every meta SMG right now. We've got the Milano, of course, we've got the Bullfrog, the MAC-10, then both MP5s. And as you can see, on pretty much every single SMG from Cold War, you're using the Sound Suppressor, the Task Force Barrel, the Tiger Team Spotlight, the Raider Stock, and then also usually a magazine as well, except for on the Cold War one, you don't use a barrel on that. Then the Modern Warfare MP5 has a bit of a different setup, but you're basically going for the same stuff. A little bit extra range, sound suppression, more mobility, all sorts of stuff like that. And of course, we have our 250 health. We're looking at chest shots here. The Milano here is in orange. As you can see up close, yeah, the Milano is not the best SMG in the world. And that's really its only area where it's not actually very effective. Up close, it will get beaten out by other weapons. The nail gun will absolutely fry it and pretty much everything else in the game. Things like the MP5s and even the Bullfrog are going to outgun it up close. However, you'll notice there is no additional damage drop-off here on the Milano. Yes, it also has an extended range when it hits that first damage drop-off. We're looking at about 20 meters here to the chest, whereas the Bullfrog is going to be 14.6 meters. The Modern Warfare MP5 is going to be 10.669. Nice. And then we've also got the Cold War MP5, which really drops off pretty severely past that 7 meter mark. And then of course you also have the MAC-10, which is up there, 14 meters it drops off, and it's actually got a slightly slower TTK than the Milano up close. So, within that like 10, 15 meter range, the Milano has the chance to get outgunned, but from 15 to 20 meters, the Milano is gonna be a great choice for an SMG. And past that, I mean, it wins by a landslide. You'll notice the MAC-10, damage drop off here, damage drop off here. So it has an additional damage drop off. The Cold War MP5, damage drop-off, another damage drop-off. The Bullfrog, damage drop-off, damage drop-off. Look at how bad the Bullfrog is past 14 meters. Its TTK is just so bad, it's only good up close. Whereas the Milano, you see it, has the one damage drop-off. It drops off at 20 meters, the TTK goes above 700, which is pretty standard, but then it is straight line all the way through at infinite range. Of course, you're not using the Milano past, 30, 40 meters max, I would say, probably, but As a hybrid SMG, the Milano is actually fantastic. And of course, we're just looking at chest shots there. If you are hitting headshots, again, up close, it's not going to be the best. And even at range, it's a lot more competitive with some of these other SMGs. But the orange line is still here at the bottom, meaning it still has one of the faster TTKs. Where it does get beaten out by, what is that? The dark blue is in the Modern Warfare MP5. It's at 65 meters, where that TTK is then overtaken, which is not a place for SMGs ever. So that's pretty much obsolete. So competitive with headshots minus that up close area, again, up through about like 12, 14 meters there. It's gonna be outgunned in some situations. Of course, it is all very situational. To the stomach again, up close, nothing too crazy, but it's still very competitive with the other SMGs. Then also to the extremities, I mean, it's gonna have that longer range, which is also crucial. It's pretty much the same as the chest shots there, 14 meters, everything else drops off by that point. The Milano stays being king from 14 to about 20, and then throughout it's still pretty competitive. It does have a pretty severe drop off to extremities, but of course you're not landing at every single shot in the exact same part of the body. If an enemy's moving, you're probably hitting a couple of chest shots, maybe a headshot if your aim's good, a stomach shot, so on and so forth. Like, nothing's ever going to be through and through to the exact same part of the body. Predominantly you're looking at chest and headshots, and overall the Milano wins over range, which is pretty important, because previously you had weapons like the MP7, which was a really good hybrid SMG. And actually, I went ahead, I added on the LC10 to this list as well, because previously the LC10 was probably the best SMG sniper support option, the best hybrid SMG, where it was really good up close, but also was pretty solid at range too. Look at the pink line here. That's the LC10. Slower up close. It's equal from 20 to 24 meters. Then it gets that additional damage drop off. So over range now, the Milano is the best hybrid SMG. It's the best SMG sniper support option, I would say. And it's just generally very, very competitive. The slower fire rate is going to hurt a bit, but there's also some other stats that the Milano has that are, I would say, pretty important. So if we go ahead and look at the summary of all the base stats for it, you look at the fire rate, obviously, the Milano is losing by a pretty significant amount. The fire rate on it is its big drawback, honestly. It's got that slower fire rate, so you're not going to be able to land as many shots as fast, but it has other things that I feel like sort of increase its overall efficiency. The ADS time, 157 milliseconds, compared to everything else, is faster. The MAC-10 is the closest, and the MAC-10 is one of the fastest weapons in the game. You're going to see here, the Milano sort of overtakes that. The sprint to fire time, 66 milliseconds. It's beaten out by the Bullfrog. It's tied with the Cold War MP5, and also the LC-10, I should say, but it beats out the MAC-10, the Modern Warfare MP5. The tactical sprint to fire time is 100 milliseconds, tied with the Cold War MP5 and the LC-10, beats out everything else. The movement speed, 5.21, better than everything else but the MAC-10, but you sort of factor in the better ADS time and whatnot, the better sprint to fire time. It's looking like the Milano has some better mobility there. The ADS movement speed, 3.98, is significantly better than most other things, with the exception of the MAC-10, where it's just 0.01 better. So when it comes to mobility, the Milano is also very, very good, and honestly better than quite a few other meta options here. The MAC-10 is the closest thing to it, but it's got different values in some areas. And of course, as we looked at on the chart, Milano outguns the MAC in quite a few different scenarios, especially over range. So statistically, the Milano is actually very good. It's very competitive. It's not the best in every single situation, but if you're using it as a hybrid SMG, if you want an SMG that has a bit of range to it, and you also want something that can be really good as a sniper support option, the Milano is now looking like one of the top choices. But there's also something else that is pretty busted with the Milano right now. Let's go ahead and jump into some gameplay, and I'll explain exactly what that is. So we're in game now. We've got our trusty Milano here, and let's take a look at something that that was brought to my attention that seems pretty interesting for the time being. We're in our usual recoil testing spot. Let's go ahead. Let's fire off the Milano. See what the recoil pattern is like, and then we're gonna try something out here and see if it's true. So as far as the recoil goes, straight vertical, then it takes a hard dip right, and then it's up and to the right horizontally. That was just the standard Milano mag. And we're not gonna go ahead, we're gonna put stopping power in. Of course, this isn't gonna be a full 55 shots of stopping power, but as we shoot stopping power, usually it's supposed to increase the recoil. That's sort of the trade-off. You get more power out of your rounds, but the recoil is a lot more noticeable. If we shoot it with stopping power here, we'll go until the rounds are done. We go over and look. It's actually less. Well, that's not how that's supposed to work. All right, we've got our stopping power rounds back again. We'll load them in. We'll do the same thing just to confirm this is what's actually happening. We're a little bit closer, obviously, this time, but we can still see the pattern the same. It doesn't move. I'm not even controlling anything. That's literally just me shooting the whole round or the whole clip. Barely moves at all. We have 27 shots left. We shoot it normally. There's actually a tad bit more recoil without the stopping power rounds than there is with the stopping power rounds. So right now, the Milano is actually secretly busted. If you have stopping power rounds, the added recoil that's there is not there at all. So this thing is even more powerful with none of the drawbacks that usually stopping power would actually add on to your weapon. And then just to close things out, this is the setup you want to use on the Milano, in my opinion. Sound suppressor, task force barrel, tiger team spotlight, 55 round drum in the Raider stock. However, if you do want to use this as a sniper support option, you could honestly go ahead and add on agency. It's going to give you that increased control even more, so it's going to have less recoil, and it's also going to increase the range and the velocity some. So the chart we looked at earlier, it'd actually be even slightly better. The drop-off would be less severe in that sense. So you could definitely get away with using agency. It's going to be a bit slower, but as a sniper support option, agency is certainly viable here. But overall, it's the standard Cold War SMG setup, and I find it works very, very well. But yeah, that's going to wrap things up for this video. The Milano, I honestly think, is one of the better SMGs, and especially as we get the TTK update in the future where the TTK gets raised, this thing I feel like is going to become even more competitive then. So just a suggestion from me, get used to the Milano. I think a lot of people are going to be using this in the future. But anyways, if you enjoyed the video, let me know by dropping a like on it. It would be seriously appreciated. And of course, if you're new here, feel free to subscribe. That way you can always stay up to date with everything going on in COD. Once again, and as always, thank you so much for tuning in. And until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.